suppose you're tired after your traveling.
Oh, yeah, it's pretty tiresome all the way in the day coach.
Well, I'll take you up to your room. It's all ready. There's nothing to do now but go to bed.
Is Father Fogarty still here?
No. They took him away this morning. Poor man. My heart went out to him.
Poor man? Why?
You'll find out. Well, I think you'll find everything you want here, Father. Sure, I couldn't get you a cup of tea now.
No, thanks. I don't understand what you mean about Father Fogarty. I'll find out. I'll find out what?
What Father Fogarty found out. Oh, the poor man.
There you go again. What happened to him?
They took him away mumbling to himself in a wheelchair.
They took him away? Where?
Shady Rest. He even said a prayer for you that your stay here might be successful and enjoyable, though he doubted it very much. You see, he had very definite ideas about running the school, about the raising and education of children, and so have they.
They?
The sisters. Father Fogarty said they wanted their way in everything. And after he was confined to a wheelchair, they had it.
Maybe he was just getting along in years.
He looked all right when he got here.
That's strange. I don't anticipate any trouble.
You don't, eh? You've never been pastor of a parochial school, then?
No, it's my first experience.
Oh. Well, I can see you don't know what it means to be up to your neck in nuns.
No.
Good night, Father.
Good night.
Sleep well tonight.
Father O'Malley.
Good morning, Father. This is our school bell. We usually ring it about an hour from now when the children are here.
I see. You think I could see Sister Superior? Is she up yet?
I'm sure she is now, Father. Will you come with me?
Yes.
Good morning, Sam.
Good morning,
Sam.
Benedict and the others are very eager to meet you, Father. Please sit down, and I'll tell her you're here.
Thank you.
Oh, I'm sorry, Father. Our cat had kittens, and they're all over the place.
Father's a member of the parish, I presume.
Excuse me, Father. I'll tell Sister you're here.
Good
morning, Father.
Sit down, please.
it has been my...
Father, this is Sister Superior. Father O'Malley, Sister Mary Benedict.
How do you do, Sister?
How do you do, Father? Sisters, this is Father O'Malley.
How do you do?
Father O'Malley is here as a substitute for Father Fogarty, who, as you know, has departed for a much-needed rest. We do hope your stay here will be a pleasant one, Father.
Thank you, Sister.
We're looking forward expectantly to your views as an educator. I'm sure that Father wishes to say a few words to us.
Well, yes, I... St. Mary's has been here a great many years. It has seen the labors of a good number of the sisters of your order. And I know that the work hasn't been easy. In the eyes of the world, very few even take notice of it. But earthly honors and rewards are not for you. You've sent forth generations of pupils who have been a credit to the teachings inculcated here. St. Mary's has grown old, doing good. As for myself, may I tell you that I'm happy I've been selected as pastor of St. Mary's. Working in a parish where there's a parish school is going to prove a new experience for me, and I'm sure a very interesting one. Yes, I see what you mean. However, as in all things, we assume the task assigned to us without complaint and take a hopeful view to the future. By the epistle of St. Peter, where he says, be sober and watch. With St. Paul. Now, just to get serious for a moment, in conclusion, may I say that I'm happy I've come to St. Paul.
I'm sorry, that's the first bell, and the sisters have to go to their classes. Would you like to say a few words to the pupils before the second bell? You may prefer speaking to the children.
I'd certainly be more at ease.
Yes.
I want to speak to you, too.
Our new pastor, Father O'Malley, wishes to speak to you. I'm sure you'll be very glad to greet him, and I'm also sure that he has something very important to say to you.
Well, children, you're going to see a lot of me in the future. I'm going to be around here a great deal. You're going to hear the shortest speech ever heard. This is a holiday. Everybody, take the day off. Pretty effective speech, huh? Oh, I had to get my self-confidence back. See, when we were kids, we used to just live for holidays. We should never get too far away from our childhood.
Do you realize what you've done? These children are liable to get into mischief. And the responsibility is yours.
Well, it seemed like a good idea.
But you can't call a holiday just like that. You have to get the permission of the superintendent of schools. What will we tell him?
Well, I'll call him. There's a man that really needs a holiday. I may give him the day off. My school wasn't like this. Yeah, I could look out the window and see fields and trees and the old swimming hole. You know, hang your clothes on the hickory limb and last one out, find them tied up in knots.
Where, Father?
Missouri.
I came from Ireland.
Thinking too gaily?
I used to.
Where are you from, sister?
I was born in Sweden, but when I was very small, I came
to... Don't tell me. In the salt,
well, that's right, Father. I love the winter. I used to ski to school, and there was one big hill left.
You carry him home after.
You wouldn't guess it, Father, but she was a tomboy from what I hear.
True.
Yes. She used to play baseball and football with the boys.
How good were you at this?
Oh, I hit over 300.
Oh, that was in the wheat belt. No. I guess we all had it better than these kids, didn't we? They haven't even got a place to play.
That used to be our playground.
Oh, over there where that is?
Yes. We had to sell the ground.
We needed money to fix our building. They were going to condemn it.
Where'd you put the money?
You'd be surprised, Father. We had to put in a new sprinkler system, new fire escapes.
And the foundation had to be reinforced. It was very expensive.
Hardly seems worth it.
We think so, Father.
Oh, yes, yes, of course. What are the other classrooms like? Say, what's going on up there?
Oh, we're repairing the roof. It leaks.
Trifle.
Very overcrowded here, too, aren't you?
Oh, yes.
A trifle.
Looks like St. Mary's is in a bad way. Trifle.
We're relying on you to help us, Father.
Bad you don't have a building like that now. That'd be your answer to everything.
That's where we intended to build our new St. Mary's. A building very much like that. There it is. Only we don't own it. Confidentially, Father, that's what we've been praying for.
You've been praying for what?
That the owner will wake up one morning and give it to us.
Who would wake up when? And give you what?
Mr. Bogardus, the owner.
That's what we're praying for.
Oh, woman, great is thy faith.
Well, if faith can move mountains,
when you figured you could just move right in, huh?
Yes.
Oh, you gotta be practical, let's face it. Does the owner know anything about this? Anybody ask him?
No, he just prayed.
That's where you could help us.
Well, what do I do when he says no?
Hey there, all of you kids, get down out of there. Why aren't you in school? You hear me?
Yeah, that's bad. They shouldn't be doing that.
After all, it's a holiday.
Who's this coming in?
Well, that's Mr. Bogardus.
I think we better go now. And you can tell him why the children aren't in school.
You want me to say anything about the building?
Some other time.
Hey! Hey, you! Here.
Well, what's going on here?
You see that fence?
Yeah.
You see what those children are? Who are you?
Well, I'm the new pastor.
Oh, you are, eh? Well, I want you to see to it that those little brats are punished.
Take care of it, Mr. Bogardus. I will censure them severely.
Oh, so you know who I am, huh?
Yes, I do.
Are you the fellow I'm supposed to do business with?
Well, I've been sent here by my superiors to make some recommendations, if that's what you mean. I've been looking over the school.
Oh, you have, eh? Well, there you are. What do you think of it?
Looks pretty tired.
Tired, eh? Tired is no name for it. And if you don't sell it to me, you got my offer, didn't you?
It's right here in my pocket.
Well, what do you say?
Difficult decision to make. I can't jump at it.
Well, I warn you, if you don't sell it to me, it's going to be condemned.
By whom?
Jim.
Oh, you are, huh?
Yes, darn right I am. And when they order you to tear it down, you've got to pay for it. You look like a practical man, Father.
You do?
Well, take my word for it. There's not a mother or father in the parish that wouldn't rather see their children over at St. Victor's. Fine, modern building. Everything up to date. Sunlight, good heat in the winter. I wouldn't think of sending my children into that fire trap.
You have any children?
No. Well, that's a long story.
Skip it.
Why?
Just being practical, Mr. Bogardus, how far do the children have to go to get the same thing?
Just about as far as I had to go when I was a child.
Well, just walk over.
Well, why not take my car? Can't walk too much. I got a bad ticket.
Let's ride out to St. Victor's and take a look.
Now you're talking. All you gotta do is close this school and send the children over to St. Victor's.
Sell the property to you.
That's right, it's that simple. Well, you can always find me. I'm here all day and every day.
I promise I won't make a move without talking to you. Take a little while, though. I'm a pretty slow thinker.
Well, you don't look it to me. No, sir.
Goodbye.
Father.
How do you do?
Are you in charge of the school here?
Well, that's a question. I have some authority.
You look like a man who could understand my language.
Well, let's find out. Start talking.
I like very much to put my daughter in school here.
Mm-hmm.
You see, I think it'd be better if she was away from me for a while. Was she bored?
Might be arranged. But why did you...
Does she need any references? I mean, well, you have to know very much about her background.
Oh, yes. That is customary.
Well, it's like this. I ran away from home when I was very young to get married. Stop me if you've heard this, Father. He left me a long time ago in Syracuse. 13 years, to be exact.
Did she get married?
Oh, yes. After a little argument. I think he was a little afraid of settling down. He was a piano player.
Oh.
He had a wonderful smile, Father.
I'll bet he had.
Very like yours. He had a little band. Kind of a non-recording orchestra. Did you ever hear of Gallagher's Gambolin?
No. Did anyone else?
I doubt it. Well, anyway, the little band got an offer to play in Cincinnati. And he promised as soon as he got a few dollars ahead, he'd send for me.
So you were left alone in Syracuse?
Till the baby came.
You've been supporting her all this time?
Mm-hmm. I suppose you're wondering as to how. So she. She's getting to be a big girl now, Father. And she's beginning to think I'm no good. I want to put her in your care before she finds out she's right.
Well, I feel anyone who's as much concerned about their daughter as you are isn't doing too badly. If there was anything really wrong with you, you wouldn't give a darn.
Joe was the only man I was ever really in love with.
Well, if you care as much for Joe as you say, why didn't you ever look him up?
I wouldn't know where to start. Besides, he ran out on me, Father.
Oh, well, that's it. Well, I'll do the best I can for you. You send your daughter to see me. What's her name?
Patricia.
I tell you, I'll make a deal with you. I'll take care of your daughter. You take care of yourself.
Thank you, Father. Father.
O'Malley.
O'Malley.
Well, goodbye, Mrs. Gallagher.
Goodbye.
Father.
Mm-hmm.
A young lady calling to see you.
Oh, yeah. Send her in. Miss Gallagher?
Yes, Father.
I've made arrangements for you to board across the street from Mrs. Green.
That would be just lovely.
My boy, take your bags. Eddie, take those bags over and put them in the back bedroom.
Okay, Mom.
Well, Patricia. you. I think the sisters were expecting someone much younger. So was I.
Oh, well, I was trying to look older, Father. I've been out looking for work. I thought maybe I could quit school and take a job. I was up real early answering ads. I'm perfectly able to take care of myself.
Mm-hmm. But Patsy, I think you're going to be very happy here at St. Mary's. You're going to enjoy every minute of it. You'll find that life can be very bright, very beautiful here. It's the character that came off. Let me take a look at you. Oh, that's fine. Yes, sir. You just give us a chance, Patsy, and we'll fix you up. What do we got here? What are you smuggling? What is this?
It's a rat, Father.
Well, you'll find around here that you can't even wear even a small mouse. Things are brightening up already, aren't they? Oh, goodness. Holy Toledo. Look at
You sent for me, sister?
Yes, Patricia. I wanted to talk to you. You're falling behind in your studies. If the work is too hard for you, Patsy, I'll be glad to help you. If there's anything I can do...
Well, that isn't it, sister. I guess I'm just sort of a featherhead.
Don't you like school? You're holding back on me, Pat. What's troubling you?
Nothing, sister.
If you'll only work a little harder, you'll get good marks. We want to send your mother a nice report card. You want your mother to be proud of you, don't you?
How's she doing?
Not very well.
Oh, no? Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
When we accepted this child, it was on your recommendation. We know very little about her parents. What kind of a home life did she have?
Oh, you know, the usual...
You said you met her mother.
Oh, yes, I have.
Do you know Mrs. Gallagher well?
Yes, I know her quite well.
And her father, did you meet him?
No, but I've heard about it.
What is his occupation?
He's a, musician. They tell me he has a charming personality, too. I like people who like music, don't you?
Are they separated?
Yes.
Is there anything that I should know that would help?
Well, that's all that I,
Care to tell?
Well, yes.
Did anyone ever tell you that you have a dishonest face? A priest, I mean.
Here, break it up. I'll knock your two heads together. The winner. You're pretty shifty, aren't you? See how you operate here. Hey. Whoop. Can't wear a glove on you. Look at your shoe. You gotta watch all the time.
Eddie, come over here. You better go inside and wash your face.
Why don't you fight back, Eddie?
You're a pretty handy lad. What's your name?
Tommy Smith, Father.
Tommy Smith. Well, keep your head up, then.
Yes, Father.
He's all right.
I think you better speak to Tommy, Father. He's a new boy here, and I'm afraid he's a troublemaker.
Oh, he's a good fighter, though.
We don't tolerate fighting in this school. I think you better speak to him. Because if he continues to pick fights, we may have to send him to another school.
Well, aren't we supposed to be educators, sister? I mean, instead of sending him away, let's try and correct him.
I observe very little correction in your attitude, Father. As a matter of fact, I detected a slight note of pride.
Naturally, I like to see a lad who can take care of himself. On the outside, it's a man's world.
How are they doing, Father?
Not doing too good, but you know what I mean. Sometimes a man has to fight his way through.
Wouldn't it be better to think your way through? Well, that's pure conjecture, of course, from someone on the inside.
Very well put, though. But don't you think sometimes in raising boys, a woman's influence can be carried too far?
You mean they may become sisters, Father?
Yes, that's right.
Well, you look after Tommy, and I look after Eddie, who lost the fight because he listened to me.
Eddie?
Yes, sister?
Come up here and I'll fix you. Let me look at that. Tell me, what is all this happening?
I was going along, minding my own business, when Tommy trips me. Although I was very mad, I controlled myself, sister, just like you said. And I said to him, why'd you do that?
Then what did you say?
Didn't say anything. Just hold off and hit me right here.
Oh, fine thing. Now then, what did you do?
I remembered what you said, sister, and I turned the other cheek. Then he really let me have it.
Well, you're a very good boy, Eddie.
I turned away to ignore him, and then he kicked me.
I'm very proud of you.
I don't feel so hot.
No, Eddie, but you really won a victory over Tommy.
Did I, sister?
Yes. You were really the better man. You and I know that.
Nobody else knows it. To tell you the truth, I don't know it. I don't think anybody was proud of me. And even if he, don't you think he thought Tommy was the best man?
Better man.
I was speaking, sister. Since I've taken such a beating, and I've been through so much, maybe I wouldn't have to go to school today. Maybe. Oh, but if you think I should go, sister, I'll go, no matter how bad I feel.
Well, maybe I'll declare a holiday. Just for you, Eddie.
Thank you.
Interested in baseball?
Yes. Tell me, have you any textbooks on the man, the art of self-defense?
I beg your pardon?
She means pugilistics. I mean boxing.
Boxing? Yes, of course. They're right over here. Now, here's a book endorsed by James J. Corbett. He won 10 straight fights. Nobody could lay a glove on him till Fitzsimmons knocked him out.
Did Mr. Fitzsimmons write a book?
No. Oh, there's a very scholarly book here by Mr. Tunney.
We'll take that.
That'll be $1. Thank you. Thanks.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Father.
Afternoon, sister. End of it now.
That's fine. It's nice of you to come on a Saturday, Eddie.
It's worth it, sister.
I'll have you know I read this whole book last night. It's just what we need.
your homework, sister?
Now, the four most valuable punches, it says here, are, now let me show you, a straight left, a right cross, a left hook, and a right uppercut. See? Now, let me see how you stand. Well, like that? How do you fight? Oh, no, 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 it's nothing like it. We have to start from the beginning. Now, let's put this foot back a bit. Back. See how I stand? Like this, and bend your knees a little bit. Bend them. Your toe should be in here. That's right. You bend your hand up like that. Yes, that looks pretty good. Your head should be down. That's right. Now, that's fine. Now, just like that. Let me see now what we do next. Yes, we start to move around. We move around a little bit, just like that. Keep shooting your left. That's right. Uh-huh. That's good. And now, Eddie, keep your chin down. Keep your chin down like this and get your shoulder up. Well, I can't do it so well in this color. But you know what I mean? You protect your chin that way, see? And another thing, you have to be weaving. That's right, and bobbing. A moving target is much harder to hit. Remember that. For instance, if I try to hit you on this cheek, yeah, then you move to the other side or you weave. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do that. You should be weaving. You see what I mean? You should be weaving. See, like that. And off. Yes, that's right. Now faster. That's right.
Gosh, sister, that's better than turning the other cheek. It's much more fun if they miss, don't you think?
Well, I'll admit it's easier on your face.
You said it, sister.
Well, now, who were we? Let me see. Although they say this is the most valuable punch of all, the left jab, it seems this is the payoff. Now we try both hands. One, Eddie, keep your mouth closed. Now, that's very important. Keep your mouth closed. The man devoted two whole pages to that. But all he meant was that if you don't, you'll be sorry. Now, keep your mouth closed. Okay. Now, I'll use you both hands. Now, if I try to hit you here, you block it with this hand, see? That's right, and you block it there, and then again. That's right. But be careful. Look out for the payoff. There are a lot of things to remember, Eddie. Lefts and rights and bobbing and weaving. Let's try them all now. Move around. Come on, here we go. Look me right in the eye. See if you can anticipate my blows. Look out now. Look out. Oh, well, that was very, very good. That's splendid. Yes, you learn fast. That's right. Now, let's go again. Come on. You're so clumsy. You have to be up on your toes. Move around quickly, you know? Oh, that's my fault. I forgot to tell you about footwork. It says there, footwork is almost the last art. It's very important. We have to learn it. Lots of fun, and you're going to like it. See? Sometimes it gets very fancy. Yes, it's... Well, maybe that's too much for the first lesson. Yes, I think so. I think we'll wait. We have enough to think about. Come on, let's just try now to try to hit me. That's right. Come on. That's right, and then let's not see. You just can't hit me, can you? No, go ahead, Eddie. Go ahead.
Well, I don't want to hit you.
Oh, don't worry. Come on, I won't be there. See? You see what I mean? You just said the...
I'm sorry, sister.
Oh, that's all right. Enough for a first lesson, though.
You forgot your footwork. You forgot something, didn't you?
Something? I forgot everything. I forgot the bob, I forgot the wee. I had my mouth open. I ran right into the payoff. Oh.
What's the matter with him, Lizzie? He's been acting very peculiar. I think he's been out in the sun too much.
Not during school hours, I hope. Good evening, Patsy.
Good evening, Father.
You're up a little late tonight, aren't you? What's the matter? You in trouble?
Father, don't you think I ought to quit school and maybe take a job?
What can you do? You have to know something to do anything. You shouldn't get discouraged, Patsy. I've been watching your marks. They're all right. They're getting better.
Oh, Father, you're just being nice. I don't know. Every time I think I know one thing, then they ask me something else. I'm just a perfect blank. Guess I haven't got what it takes.
Oh, now, don't you ever think you're dumb.
All right, Father. Let's just say I'm not very bright.
What's the problem tonight? Why are you up so late?
It's an essay, Father.
The five senses. That's an interesting subject. What have you discovered about them?
Nothing. See what I mean?
Well, what are the five senses, Patsy?
Well, to see, to hear, to taste, to smell, to feel.
That's right. Who's the essay for?
Sister Benedict.
Sister Benedict? Oh, we'll have to take dead aim on this one. See if we can get you an A. No, but you don't want to be like the rest of the class. They're all going to come up with the same stereotyped answers. We want to be different, be unique. We'll write Sister an essay on another sense, huh? Let's see. Man is endowed with certain powers, which we call the five senses. Now, if he has common sense, he'll get great happiness out of life by using these powers within right reason. For instance, you're happy you came to St. Mary's, aren't you?
Yes, Father.
Be glad you're alive. To be grateful because people are kind to you. To be able to see some of nature's great wonders. The budding of the flowers in spring and the changing leaves in the autumn. To be able to appreciate beautiful music. To be conscious of the beauty of tasting and feeling and hearing only the things that are good for you. To be aware of why you're here. Go on and on and on, but...
Well, why don't you, Father?
I think I will.
Every time you're near a road, aren't you glad you've got a nose? And if the dawn is fresh with dew, aren't you glad you're you? When a meadow lark appears, aren't you glad you've got two ears? And if your heart is singing too, aren't you glad you're you? You can see a summer sky or touch a friendly hand or taste an apple pie. Pardon the grammar, but ain't life grand? And when you wake up each morn, aren't you glad that you were born? Think what you got the whole day through. Aren't you glad you're you?
Well, Patsy, I'll leave you with those few little thoughts. What do you make of them?
Well, if you can't appreciate your five senses, then your life isn't worth 5 cents.
That's good. Good. Hope you do well tomorrow.
Thank you, Father. I feel much better.
I feel pretty good myself.
Children, I'm putting you on your honor. Who did this? It's your duty to tell. your visit, Father. Be seated, children. Want to take my chair? We'll take this matter up later. Now we'll continue. I want you to read what you've written so Father Manor may hear it. Luther.
Luther? How'd he get in here?
We never knew.
The Five Senses. I'd like to see a good movie with Roy Rogers. I like the taste of ice cream cones, especially strawberry. I like to listen to the Lone Ranger. Hi-ho, Silver! I like the smell of hot dogs at the ballpark. I like the feel. Good.
Well, don't laugh, children, don't laugh. Luther means he wants to be a good boy. You want to feel good in here, don't you, Luther?
No, sister. What I meant to feel good is like when the bell rings at 3 o'clock or when it's Easter vacation, better still. That's how I meant to feel good.
Well, it has both honesty and imagination. So you can sit down. And now, Patricia.
The six senses.
Well, the subject I gave you was the five senses.
Well, I chose for my subject six senses.
Well, go on, Patricia, go on.
The six senses. To see, to hear, to taste, to smell, to feel, to be. And the most important is the last. The sixth sense is to be able to enjoy the five senses properly. To be. That's what really matters. It's like a world inside us, and it's up to us what we make of it. We see others, we hear others, we know others with our five senses. But how do we ever know ourselves? Through common sense. Common sense, whose function it is to differentiate between the various reports of the senses, or to reduce these reports to the unity of a common perception. Two great words, to be. Other words grow out of them. I am, you are, he is, we are, they are. That sort of takes in everybody. As Shakespeare said, to thine own self be true, and it shall follow as the night the day. Thou canst not then be false to any man. And he was so right, sister. He was just talking about the sixth sense. To put it in my own words, to be or not to be, that is the question.
Very good, Patricia. Very good.
And one more thing, sister.
Save for the bell.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, amen. You may go now, children.
Something. She shows a lot of promise, don't you think?
Oh, definitely.
What are you going to give her, a B, perhaps?
Oh, no, I think an A.
Good, that's fine.
As a matter of fact, I think it should be maybe an A plus, don't you, Father?
Oh, well, that might be overdoing it a little.
It had a plus quality to it.
Yeah, well, a girl like Patsy needs a lot of encouragement. She has such a fine mind.
Yes, remarkable. In fact, she has the mentality of a man your age.
There's another sense, you know, sister.
Oh, don't tell me.
Yeah, sense enough to know when to leave.
Hey.
Morning, sister.
Hey.
Little Bobby wants to play with you.
shake hands, and we'll be friends. I'll even buy you an ice cream cone.
Two scoops?
Two scoops.
Okay.
Say, Eddie, how did you learn to fight?
That's yeah, how about that?
You missed some excitement here.
I did?
Yes, you did. Yes, you did. It was quite a fight. That little Eddie there, that is Eddie, isn't it?
Oh, yes. Yes, that's Eddie.
That's the little boy that was in that fight a few weeks back?
Mm-hmm, yes.
Quite a change. It's incredible. He's an improved man.
I wonder, does it mean anything, Father? Does it prove anything to beat up your fellow man? Somehow, don't you think it's what we are in here that matters? I mean to be.
You're so right. But how do you account for such a sudden change in such a short time?
Oh, we try to do our best to raise masculine little men with our limited knowledge of the outside world. Children can't keep their minds on what they're doing. It's the first grade, you know, and they're easily distracted.
You mean we're making too much noise?
To use your own words, yes, Father.
Oh, well, Sister, we heard about your play. We prepared a little surprise for you. You know, you can't have a Christmas play without Holy Night or a Dusty Fidela.
Oh, yes, yes.
Do you mean there's no room in your play for Holy?
Not in our play, Father.
What?
I'd certainly like to see a play like that.
Well, would you like to see a rehearsal?
Yes, I certainly would. You can't stay here and practice a while. I'm going to check into this. What are you going to use for music?
Come with me and you'll find out. Bobby! Bobby! Well, here he is. Here's the little man I was telling you about.
Oh, no, no. Bobby, he's an old pal of mine. You in the play, Bob?
Yes, in fact, I read it up.
Oh, I bet you got a good part, huh?
Yes, it's beautiful.
Can we see the play now, Bobby?
Well, it's a little bit not good. You see, we're just practicing it. It'll be better at Christmas.
Yeah, but we won't mind a few mistakes.
No, what's the play about?
Oh, that's what I tell you at the beginning.
Well, why don't we begin? You ready?
I must tell you, the children have done this all by themselves. Every time they do it, the dialogue is different. Every line is a surprise to me. Heaven knows what it's going to be at Christmas.
They do it in front of their parents. They'll probably forget everything.
This is Mary and I'm Joseph, and we're going to Bethlehem to see if we can find some place to stay. And that's all you have to know, really. Knock, knock. Hello? This is Mary and I'm Joseph, and we came to Bethlehem to see if we could find a place to stay.
Well, do you have any money?
No, sir.
Well, then you can't stay here tonight.
Well, that's too bad for us. Now we can't stay there because we don't have any money.
I'll be all right, Joseph, as long as I'm with you.
Well, you see, I think we ought to find a house because it might rain or snow. It's winter, you know.
Why don't you try next door?
Good idea.
Knock, 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 knock.
Can't stay here because you don't have any money.
I didn't even ask you yet. Go back and start again.
Knock, 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 knock.
Hello, hello there. This is Mary and I'm Joseph. And could we stay here for the night, please?
Do we have any money?
No, but Mary's awfully tired. Could you think it over?
Okay.
What did he say, Joseph?
He said he'd think it over.
When will he know?
I don't know.
Hey, Joseph. I saw it over. You can stay in the stable.
Well, glory be! Did you hear that?
Yes, Joseph.
The next scene will be the Lord Jesus' birthday.
Go on back. You're in the plane. Don't come here. Go.
His baby brother.
Well, here we all are in the stable. And we're very happy here in Bethlehem. And there's our star, here's our angel, there are the shepherds, and here are the wise men, there, and there. And all here, and the neighbors are coming in, bringing their presents, because it's his birthday. Thank you. You make Mary and I very happy.
What do you do now, Bobby? Sing Holy Night, perhaps?
No, Father. We have another song.
Oh, how's it go?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jesus. Happy birthday to you.
Oh, their simplicity is beautiful. I wouldn't change a word of it.
Oh, but they will.
You won't be needing my talents at Christmas.
No, Father.
Maybe at the Easter time I could stage an egg hunt, hmm?
Mm-hmm. Look, sister. It's Father O'Malley. I hope he finds him in a favorable mood. He could be. It's spring, you know.
No, we're not getting anywhere, Father. We got
to... Well, it's a difficult decision to make, Mr. Bogardus. To decide that there'll be no more St. Mary.
If you ask me, it's not much now.
It is to the sisters. You see, to you, that school is just a piece of property. But to them, it's everything. It's not just the idea of selling you the property, it's the thought of selling them out.
Now you're getting a little sentimental, aren't you, Father?
Well, it's just that I've been here long enough to find out how they feel.
What are they going to do when it's condemned?
They expecting a miracle.
A miracle? What kind of a miracle is going to get them out of trouble?
You'd be surprised.
No, no, Delphine, you're not doing it right.
Show me, sister.
You don't hold it right, for this is the way you should hold it. And straight. And then you chop it. Don't chop like that. Keep your hands together and step into it. You see?
Help him, sister. Come on, throw.
No, I don't think so. You better do it.
Doggone those kids. There they go again.
Here's your chance, Bogartis. They're coming over to apologize. Why don't you ask them if they're willing to sell?
You mean if it's all right with them, it's all right with you?
Oh, definitely. I'll recommend it. Of course, you'll have to see the bishop.
The bishop?
Oh, yes, he has the final word.
What kind of a man is he to do business with?
You'll be glad to come back to me. And you'll have to anyway, because I have to give you a letter so you can see the bishop. And I can't give you a letter to see the bishop until you straighten yourself out with the sisters. Here they come now. Good luck.
Oh, I'll never get this deal closed.
Is he very angry?
I think you'll find him quite forgiving.
You mean forgiving?
Do you mean it would be a good time to ask him, Father?
Never be any better.
We are so sorry, Mr. Bogartis.
It's nothing, sister. He's perfectly all right.
We'll pay for it.
Don't think of it, sister. It's nothing. It's a little hard to get glass today, but I get it.
It is a magnificent building you have here.
Thank you, sister. I know exactly how you feel when I look at that tumble-down school of yours. I have one problem, however, before my dream is complete. It's a parking problem. You see, the Bogartis Corporation will have several hundred employees, and they all have cars. Parking's becoming more of a problem every day. You see, here's where my desk's going to be. Here are the blueprints.
It would take us years to raise the money to build a building like this.
Oh, you could never do it. You'd be surprised what it's cost me. Just follow me.
Shall we ask him now?
Ever seen anything like this?
It's tremendous, Mr. Bogartis.
15,000 square feet without a column. Balcony seats 400. We can hold dances here, conventions, everything.
It certainly is ideal. It's perfect. The Lord must have been the architect.
I wish he had been. I had Butler and Dean, a couple of thieves. Robbed me right and left. Cost me 30% over the estimate.
But you must be very happy with your accomplishment.
There's just one thing could make me happier, and you know that.
I believe we're thinking about the same thing.
Yeah?
It isn't what we acquire in life, is it? It's what we give. And this is a monument to you. I can see the cornerstone reading, donated to St. Mary's through the generosity and benevolence of Horace P. Bogartis. Oh, you're a very fortunate man, Mr. Bogartis.
I am.
You know, it's more blessed to give than to receive. This will live long after your dust. That is real happiness. Can't you just picture that?
Would you mind saying that again? Picture what? When I'm dust?
But you don't have to make up your mind right away.
Why don't you sleep more?
I can't sleep now.
I know you're surprised, but you shouldn't. Sometimes we don't know why we do things. You didn't know why you built this building.
I didn't. I thought I did.
No. You built it in answer to our prayer.
We've been praying and praying for this. And we're going on praying.
Do you mean to say that you got the idea that...
We leave you now. With this thought. Donated to St. Mary's through the generosity and benevolence of Horace P. Bogardus.
Generosity, benevolence, and dust.
I'm sure that nice little man is going to give us his building. You must pray and keep on praying until God will be down. And may God's will be ours, then.
But what if our prayers aren't answered?
Oh, thou of little faith. We have reason to know. More things are wrought by prayer than this world dreams of. Therefore, let thy voice rise like a fountain, night and day. And come on.
What's all the excitement? Notre Dame win another one?
Oh, no. No. They asked him.
And?
He didn't say no.
Oh, so you finally got here, eh? Been waiting for you fellas since 6 o'clock.
Will you stop flying off the handle? You're working too hard, Horace. You ought to be home in bed.
With this building on my hands, should have been ready for occupancy 3 months ago. You don't know how much money I'm losing.
You talked about money. Now, why don't you see your banker? I'm your doctor. You can't go on like this, Horace.
You know what I'm going through. Took me 3 weeks to get that piece of glass.
There you are, brother. Sign this, will you?
What's this? What's all this?
What's all what? Sign it.
I want to know what I'm signing. I can't sign
that. That's overtime. We get time and a half after 6 o'clock.
Well, you should have been here before 6. I was here. Didn't even leave to go to my doctor's
office. Listen, Bub. One more crack out of you. We'll take that glass back, and it'll take you 6 weeks to get it put in again. Sign it.
See what I'm up against?
Calm down, Horace.
The way they do, say?
You mustn't let anything upset you.
Yeah, I know about it.
You're too big a man for that.
Yeah, not so big.
Mm. Go home and get a good night's rest.
Oh.
Nothing can take the place of a good night's sleep.
Mm-hmm.
Rest. Tranquility. Relax. Why, a man in your position hasn't got a worry in the world. Just keep saying to yourself.
Yeah, I can say it, but I won't feel it.
Now what's the matter?
You know what they're doing to me. I'll stop that.
What's the matter with you, Horace? First you're out of patience. Now you're out of class.
Now you want me to sleep.
What's new, Horace? I heard the crash. I wondered if anybody got hurt.
Oh, Father O'Malley, Dr. McKay, my physician.
How do you do, Doctor?
I'm glad to know you, Father.
Thank you. Hey, that's really too bad. Isn't class a little hard to get these days, Horace?
Oh, hard to get. Say, can't you get him to stop that, Father?
Stop it, Horace? Why, I think it's beautiful. His nerves are all shot.
Hardly noticeable.
No. What is that, Father? Isn't that O Sanctissima?
That's right, Doctor.
Beautiful. I've heard it many times. Mm-hmm. How do the words go?
You know it, too?
Manestin te,
wondering. Talk so important you couldn't tell me over the telephone.
Well, I don't know just how to go about breaking
it. Is it about Pat?
Yes.
Oh, what's happened, Father? Oh, what's wrong? What's she done?
Not bad news, necessarily. In fact, this could be good news.
I'm so glad. She's been getting along so well. Well, if anything should happen to upset her now...
Take it easy. Nothing has happened.
What's it got to do with Patsy that you said it had something to do with Patsy?
Well, it has. I found her father.
Joe.
I think so. I told him the story as you told it to me. I described you to him. And
how on earth did you run him down?
Well, he's a piano player. Once a piano player, always a piano player. I got him through the musicians' union. I went right to the top. Patrillo.
I really don't know what to say.
Neither do I.
Well, is he in town?
In town? He's here. He's out in the hall.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Shall I bring him in?
Oh, no. Not, but that is... Wait just a minute, will you?
You know.
Mind you, it's 13 years. I was a little bit young.
Well, he hasn't exactly been on ice yet.
Well, shall we? Neither of you, Joe. Do me a favor, will you?
What's that?
Play the piano.
Oh.
Please. I want Father to hear you. I've been telling him all about you. Don't let me down. Listen to this, Father. He's really good. What was that song we used to love so much?
You mean, By the Sea?
No, Chip. No, it had a bit of the rosary in it. But that wasn't enough. Joe, don't you remember? We said that no matter what happened, that song would always see us through. And then we pressed the rosebud in the bowl. What happened?
Yeah. Where's the book?
What's the matter, Father? Do you know it?
Why, sure. That's an old song called In the Land of Beginning Again.
What?
Why'd you say so? You never asked me.
Oh, well, come on over here and get in there.
You'll be sorry.
There's a land of beginning again, where skies are always blue, though we've made mistakes, that's true. Let's forget the past and start life anew. Though we wander by a river of tears, where sunshine won't come. find that paradise where sorrow can't live, and learn the teachings of forgetting in the land of beginning again, where broken
big moment in their lives. Incidentally, it's the first time they're wearing high heels.
Look, sister.
Yes, well, that's really nice, Patsy. Push the sleeve up a little bit like that. Fun, I think it's a bit long.
Oh, it's supposed to be, sister.
Yes, but not too. Only on one side.
Right here.
Oh, yes,
so
over here, because you don't want to stop.
Oh, look, girls. Sister Benedict's giving Patsy all these hints.
Oh, no, Delphine, that isn't right.
Patsy's teacher's pet.
Meow.
She is, too. You gave her the prettiest dress. It would look much better on me, I'm sure.
Oh, girls, I think that's about enough. You better take your dresses off. That's enough.
Sister, I just got a funny idea. Suppose, after all of this, I flunk. Wouldn't that be terrible?
Don't worry about that. You wouldn't do that to us, would you?
Oh. Can I ask you any questions?
No.
This would be a great idea to cut out the finals entirely.
Well,
yeah.
Oh, no, you can't get around me that way. Run along now. Take the dresses off. Be careful.
Sister, I was just thinking, could I take this dress over and show it to my mother?
Yes, certainly. I think that would make her very happy.
Thank you, sister. I know it will.
Okay, darling, I'll get the tickets to Syracuse. Goodbye, Joe.
This one two ways, sister. Yes and no.
All right. Thanks.
Thanks.
I'm sorry, Patsy. Time is up.
May I come in?
Certainly.
Oh, don't get up. I'm just the pastor here. Grading the papers, I see.
Yes.
With curiosity about their marks. I'm supposed to come in and, without your knowing, of course, find out how they turned out. I presume you opened your heart and passed them all, didn't you?
All but one, Father.
Patsy? subject.
The others are even worse. Her average is below 60.
Well, she got the date right, and she spelled her name right. Couldn't you give her something on that and add it up again, maybe faster?
Don't you think the honor of the school means anything?
But what about Patsy? St. Mary's isn't being very much help to her. Don't you think we should help a child like that? Just beginning to believe in herself, and a blow like this, the child may never get over it.
Do you believe in just passing everybody, Father?
Maybe. Maybe I do.
I can't believe you mean it.
Well, it's easier for some children to make the grade than others. They don't have to study. But I've known some that get the best marks in school and never made much of a mark afterwards. I knew a character once, a fellow named Elmer Hathaway. He and I went through school together. Or rather, I went through school. Elmer just stood still. I think he was 3 years in the eighth grade. He was quite a boy. The teacher often wondered how he found his way to the schoolhouse. Sometimes he didn't. Kids used to make fun of him. He was sort of a dreamer. Sometimes he'd even forget what day it was, and he'd come to school on Saturday. Asked him who Plato was one day, and he said, Plato who? But he was good with his hands. He built a boat, a sailboat. One time he disappeared for, two or three days. When he came back, they asked him where he'd been, and he said, oh, just sailing. Well, he got to be about a foot taller than anybody else in the class. They felt sorry for him, so they decided to pass him. Besides, I think they needed the desk at the time. He never knew about it, and from that time on, he developed assurance. You've heard of the Hathaway shipyards, haven't you?
Yes.
That's Elmer. And to this day, he takes care of his less fortunate pals. You know, the ones that used to get 99 and 100. Any of them are broke or out of a job, they can always work for Hathaway. He's a good man. By the way, just what is passing, anyhow?
75, you know.
Yes, I know that, but who started it?
Our school is based by it. Every school is, if we don't have standards.
Yeah?
But certainly you're not serious.
I am. Aren't we here to give the children a helping hand, or are we here to measure their brains with a yardstick? Why do they have to have 75 to pass?
You would put the standard at 65, Father?
Why not?
Then why not at 55? Why any grades at all? Why don't we close the school and let them run wild?
Maybe. Be better than breaking their hearts.
That's unfair, Father. My heart aches for Patty, and when you infer it doesn't hurt me, you're being very unjust. Please realize I've done everything possible to help her, but I must uphold our standards. If you order me to pass her, I shall do so. But her mark remains the same. Come in, Patsy.
Your sister. Hello, Father.
Patsy?
I failed in my sister.
Yes, you did, Patsy.
That's what I thought.
I'm sorry.
Well, that's all right, sister. I was just thinking that, well, I won't be needing this now, and what don't being like it so much. I was just thinking that. I was just thinking that maybe I'll do better next year, sister.
Sister, you and I have had our little differences of opinion, but they haven't been important. This is serious. I'm not going to order you to do anything. It's up to you, but...
But she failed.
Thank you.
happened?
Sister Benedict's quite ill. She had a fainting spell in the chapel.
Did you call a doctor?
She doesn't want one.
Oh, she doesn't, huh?
Come in.
The doctor's on his way over. How are you feeling, sister?
Who sent for a doctor?
She did.
You can't trust the man. He's an informer.
How are you feeling?
I feel all right. Won't you sit down, Father? I want to talk to you.
What have I done now?
You've been writing. You've been writing to Mother General.
Oh.
Going over my head. Yes, I received that letter from her.
Well, I just wrote expressing my own opinion, sister. But I hope that hasn't brought this on.
No, I'm just tired. But you actually considered tearing down St. Mary's and sending our children to St. Victor's.
That's right. I thought about it quite a bit. We have to face facts, sister. Take it easy.
Pardon me, but the doctor...
Come in. Come in, doctor.
Hello, Father.
It's Dr. McKay, sister.
How do you do, sister?
He's Mr. Bogardus' doctor, you know.
Oh, yes? Are you his personal physician?
Yes. I have other patients, possibly 100 or so, and Horace B. Bogardus. Lately, he's been a full-time job. Brings me up all hours of the night.
We pray for him all the time.
That's very nice. He certainly could use it. But may I ask why?
Well, they need a new school, doctor, and they're praying for Mr. Bogardus to give them his building.
Give? Bogardus? Pardon me.
All right, I have a sense of humor.
Yeah, well, maybe your prayers are having some effect on him. He can't sleep nights. That's why I'm giving him sleeping tablets. Prayer is a wonderful thing, Father, but if Bacardus ever gives you that building, I'll,
The pipe up nothing spectacular, Doctor.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, I can't do much here. If you're well enough to come down to the office tomorrow, I'd like to give you a checkup.
But there's nothing wrong with me. I'm just tired.
I know, but you let me be the judge of that. I want to find out the cause of your being tired.
She'll be there, Doctor.
You keep right on praying, sister. But not tonight. You need a good night's rest.
So does Bogardus.
Yes, that's right.
You heard what the man said. You take it easy.
Now, you won't forget, Father. You'll see that she gets down to the office tomorrow.
She has a mind of her own, you know. I'll get her down there.
Is this anything serious? Well, she's running a little temperature. You say she's had these attacks before?
That's what I heard today, yes. I hope it's nothing serious. She's such a remarkable woman.
She certainly is. I could tell that the minute I walked into the room. Does she really believe that Bogardus is going to give that building? Well, I've heard of such things, but I've never come across it before. Not since I was a little boy and I wished for what I wanted for Christmas and got it.
Sort of the same thing.
But when we grow up, we get practical. She's not very practical.
She thinks she is.
What is she going to do when she doesn't get it?
Now she's got you worried.
Yes, she has. I hate to see her disillusioned.
Say, Doctor, not to change the subject much, but Bogardus has a bad heart, hasn't he?
Yes.
What are you giving him for, pills?
Well, I've got a better prescription.
Well, I knew a fellow once. He had a very bad heart. In fact, they only gave him 6 months to live. But he spent that 6 months doing so much good. Do you know that he lived to be 90?
That's so. You mean doing good for others is good for a bad heart?
You spend your life doing for others, don't you, Doctor?
Yes. Yes.
How's your heart?
Fine.
There you are.
Are you tampering with the laws of medicine?
Well, we have a good deal in common, Doctor. We're both interested in the good heart.
And your suggestion is, perchance, that I change my prescription?
You're the doctor.
I'm not so sure, O'Malley. Good day.
Good day. Father O'Malley.
Oh, yes, Father O'Malley. Excuse me, I didn't see you.
I thought it was you, but you seemed to be looking right past me.
Oh, my mind was a million miles away.
Yes, you don't seem to be yourself today.
Oh, I'm not, Father. I've just come from my doctor. You know, Father, if I had to live my life over again, there'd be a lot of changes made. Yeah, a lot of changes. You know, there's great beauty in this world. If you just have the eyes to see it. Isn't there, Father?
Oh, naturally. Thank you.
Yes, life can be very beautiful.
Right.
And you know, Father, you've spent your whole life doing things for people.
No.
Yes, you have. Come to think of it, Father, how's your heart?
Great, great.
That's what I mean. Would it be all right, Father, if I go into the church?
You're perfectly welcome. There it is. And here's a thought that might help you. Meant a lot to me. I shall pass this way but once. If there's any good I can do for anyone, let me do it now and not put it off. For I shall not pass this way again.
Oh, thank you, Father. God bless you. Thank you.
Goodbye.
Thank you.
Well, I mean, it doesn't matter. I see that animals love you.
Oh, Oh, yes, but people don't.
Oh, you must be wrong. I'm sure that when people get to know you, they love you.
No, that's when they don't. You see, sister.
Yes, got it.
I've never had any children of my own. And I've never even liked children. And they don't like me.
Why don't people like you?
Well, I've been very selfish. And lately, I've been giving it a lot of thought.
Come to any conclusion?
Yes. This is going to surprise you. And I do want people to like me. So, I was wondering if you would accept my building. What's the matter? It's a bit of a shock to you. Well, you can have it. You can have it. I'll go straight to my lawyer and have him make out the deeds right away.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Bogardus. St. Mary's will never forget it, and the children will love you.
They will? I'll have the necessary papers made out right away.
Yes.
Come on, doggy. Come on.
Sister, that was lovely. What is it called?
Oh, it means, it's spring.
Don't let me slow you up. Sing something else.
But what do we know?
How about, you know Birmingham Bertha?
Dune.
How about the school song, then?
Oh, yes. Sister has a new version of it with effects and everything. She's a bit proud of it.
We'll sing that.
Won't you sing the melody, Father?
Sister, you talked me into it.
We always
that in years. I had to try it.
Mr. Benwick was in to see me.
She's in great spirits, Doctor. Probably the happiest person alive. Isn't it wonderful what faith can do?
Father, everyone's so happy around here. I hate to be the bearer of bad news. I examined Sister Benedict. Could she be sent away for a while?
Why? Where?
Oh, someplace like Arizona, for instance. See this area here?
Yes, what is it?
That's the right lung. And here, in this area...
I never could make anything out of those things. What is it, Dr. TB?
Yes. A very early stage. Oh, it's not that bad. We're lucky to catch it right now. That's what I meant when I asked if she could be sent to a drier climate. To an infirmary or a home for old people. Some place where she could have light duties. Not another school.
It has to be done. I guess it can be done. Not to be with children.
Not for a while. Not until this condition is cleared up.
Does she know about this?
Not yet. It's very important that she does know it. She has a wonderful vitality, a natural optimism, and that's the best medicine anyone can have. If that spirit is dampened, it would have a depressing effect and delay her recovery.
If she'll have to know about it. We can't just send her away without...
Don't you people more or less go where you're told without question?
Yes, we're supposed to have the stamina to take it.
She has plenty of that.
But you don't quite understand, Doctor, you see. Sister and I haven't always agreed on how to run a school. But one rather serious difference in opinion. Now if she's sent away without any explanation, she's bound to think that...
Up to here, Father, we were discussing her health. What's best for her? And now we're discussing your feelings.
A heck of a way to put it, Doc.
I only want to see her get well.
Well, I guess I can see to it that she's transferred. But not to tell her why. Send her away without any explanation. He would put it that way. Her opinion of me or... her health.
Right on, Jim. Father, you're in the way.
Yeah, let me help you with that.
There. Oh, just put it down there. That'll do for now. I'm so glad you came over, Father. I have so much on my mind, and I want you to help me.
Too,
now, when you bring the desk, we'll put it over here.
Yes, sister.
Let's go where there's less noise. And now we can finally tear down our old school, and that can become our playground. It's all so wonderful. And I'm tired. I think I'll sit down for a minute.
You've been working too hard. You shouldn't be lifting things around here.
Oh, it must be all the excitement. Now, what was it I was going to say? Yes, about commencement. Did you ask Mr. Bogardus?
Yes, and the doctor.
Fine. He's a nice man. He telephoned and told me that I had nothing to worry about. Yes, I'd have you know that he said there was nothing wrong with me. I'm perfect.
Well, that is good news.
Yes.
Oh, Bob Bogardus, you want me to thank him publicly?
Oh, yes, by all means. And convey our sincere gratitude for his wholehearted generosity. But don't make it long.
Just here, I'll be the soul of brevity.
Well, the children would be restless, and the parents would be interested on them then. But, of course, you'll impress upon the graduating class that they must never give up their pursuit of learning, and at all times carry up the most into the ideal. St. Mary's. Yes, I think that'll take care of everything, Father.
I think I'm going to be long-winded. Why don't you write the speech?
I have, Father. I have it here. And I have one more wish. The next year will be a joyous and successful one, and that we will never have any more misunderstandings. Serious ones, I mean. I know how you feel about Patsy. You still disagree with me, don't you? Father, sometimes we have to do things that aren't easy. No matter how much they hurt us, we have to do what we believe is right.
I have something to tell you, sister, that isn't going to be easy.
What is that, Father?
Will you be notified shortly? The Sister Michael is going to be in charge here next year.
Her assistant.
It's only fair to tell you, sister, that you're being transferred.
But we shouldn't become too attached to any one place. Any other school may seem strange at first, but as long as I am around children, I'll be happy. How do you know? Have you been writing Mother General again? Will I be here for graduation?
Yes, sister, of course.
Is this the desk that goes in your office, sister?
Yes. Yes. Was there anything else you had to say, Father? That was all?
Sister has it. It didn't fit me.
Too many milkshakes.
Yeah. Well, better luck next year. I'll be rooting for you.
Thank you.
Have you exercised it?
I guess so.
You didn't tell her you're not graduating?
No, sister.
My dear child, why not?
She's been out of town.
It's embarrassing, Patsy, I know. But you mustn't feel so badly about not graduating. If we don't fail sometimes, our successes won't mean anything. But you must have courage. Don't give up. I'll explain to your mother so she won't think ill of you. I know she loves you and you love her. And where there's love, there's complete understanding.
Understanding? You ask me, nobody understands anything. You don't understand anything. Father O'Malley doesn't understand anything. My mama doesn't. Sister, I'm sorry.
What is troubling you, Patsy?
Oh, sister, help me. Oh, please help me.
Yes, of course. Of course I want to help
you. I want to be a nun, sister. How can I become a nun like you?
There's one thing I do know. Something is troubling you.
No. No, I just want to be a nun.
You don't say it that way, my dear. I want to be a nun. You don't become a nun to run away from life, then. It's not because you've lost something. It's because you found something. You're still a little girl. You don't know yet.
Oh, but I do. I just want to be like you.
You don't know what the next 4 years will bring. You haven't been to high school yet. Those are years you'll always treasure. New companions, new interests, lots of fun, as well as study. Going to parties, football games, your first prom. First walls. You can't give up these things if you know nothing about them. Not until you've known all this and more. Can you say with complete understanding, I want to be a nun?
Oh, but I can't. I can't. I know them all now.
Well, then, Patsy, that's another thing. Your marks aren't good enough. You have to pass your examinations.
But I couldn't. I could have passed. I didn't want to.
You mean you failed on purpose?
I thought maybe I could stay here another year. Everything's so nice here, sister. You don't know. But everything's so clean and so good and... Well, even if I am in the same grade, I don't care. I'd be with you.
I'm beginning to see what's wrong. Did Father O'Malley know about this?
Nobody knew, sister. Nobody but me.
I...
No, sister, you're wrong. But can be used as a preposition as well as a conjunction. And then it takes the objective case.
Oh, dear me. Now, that wasn't the examination, wasn't it?
Uh-huh, and I missed it. Well, I'm brighter than you think I am, sister. Go ahead, ask me some more questions. Honestly, I wouldn't be a dumb nun.
Sister, this is Mr. and Mrs. Joe Gallagher, Patsy's mother and father. How do you do? Patsy, your father.
Hello, Patsy.
children over now, as often as you like. You won't be lonely anymore.
Oh, Mama. Oh, Mama. Is this my real daddy?
Yes, darling.
We came to see you graduate, Patrick. Isn't it time you were getting ready?
We were just about to get ready. Weren't we, Patsy?
Yes, sister.
How were her marks, Father? I didn't see her report card.
Her marks, though, they were exceptional. There wasn't a child in the class anywhere near her. Dear friends, this is indeed a great day for St. Mary. I might call it the first birthday of the new St. Mary. There's the old, and here's the new. And we owe it all to the generosity and the benevolence of one man. A man whose name will be graven on our cornerstone and in our hearts for many years to come. And speaking of hearts, a truly great heart beats in the bosom of Mr. Horace P. Bogartis. Bogardus is a very modest man. But when you have a heart that loves children, that thinks only of others, and that's capable of doing so much good, then, my friends, you have a heart that can laugh at the years. Mr. Bogardus is a fine example of the joy of giving. To him, every day is Christmas. Indeed, he has holly in his heart.
Thank you.
St. Mary's is founded on faith, hope, and charity. The greatest of these is charity.
And a gift to the church, you know, is deductible.
Thank Mr. Bogardus for his generous gift. Now I'd like to say a few words to the boys and the girls in our graduating class. I'm going to make it very brief. Today is a joyous one for you because you're graduating. It's also a sad one because you're leaving St. Mary. I can't sum up in a few minutes what you've learned here in 8 years. What you're taking with you is not just what was in the books. That's important, but it isn't everything. What you are taking with you is what you have to give now to others. What the good sisters have taught you. I want to say right here that if any of you are ever in trouble, no matter what, you just dial O for O'Malley.
cab?
Yes, it'll be waiting outside. Sister Benedictine Chapel?
With Mrs. Angela.
Goodbye, sister. Goodbye, sister.
Goodbye, sister.
Goodbye, sister. Goodbye, sister. Goodbye, sister. You know, wherever I am, my heart will always be with St. Mary's.
Bye, sister.
Bye, sister.
Sister, we know your heart will be here. We'll always remember you in our prayers.
Thank you. Goodbye, Father.
Goodbye. Sister. Sister Benedict. Sister, I can't let you go like this. You know, when Dr. McKay said you were perfect, he was right. That's what you are. But he didn't mean physically. Because, sister, you have a touch of tuberculosis. Dr. McKay felt that you shouldn't know about this, but I...
Thank you, Father. Thank you. You've made me very happy. I'll get well quickly now.
Of course you will, sister.
Of course I will.
And if you ever need anything, no matter what it is or wherever you happen to be,